Hi dear children, how are you? In the last class we learned about several agricultural activities. First one, preparation of soil, then second one sowing, then third one adding manure and fertilizers, then protection from weeds, irrigation, then harvesting. Okay, today we are going to discussing next agricultural activity is storage. Storage. After harvesting, the grains are stored for longer time. Storage is an important task in agriculture. If the grain seeds are kept for longer time, they should be safe from pest or insect, microorganisms, moisture, rats, etc. The freshly crop has more moisture. If the crops are stored without drying, what happens? If freshly harvested crop are kept for without drying, they should be attacked by some pest or insect. And insect or pest, they damage these crops and decreasing in the capacity of germination. Hence, before storing them, the crop seeds are kept dried in the sun to reduce the moisture in them. And this helps to avoid the attack of insect or pest, rat, microorganisms, etc. The farmers store the grains in large jute bag or metallic bins. However, large scale of grains are stored in silos or granaries to avoid the attack of pest or insect and rat, etc. Okay, so storage is the one of the most important tasks in agriculture. And before storing them, the grain seeds are kept for longer time. They should be safe from insect, microorganisms like fungi, bacteria, rats and moisture, etc. The freshly crops have more moisture. These crops kept without drying, what would happen? They should be spoiled or attacked by some microorganisms and they damage these seeds. So storage is one of the most important tasks in agriculture. Okay dear children, this is our last point in our agricultural activities, storage. There are several agricultural activities. First one, preparation of soil, then sowing, adding manure and fertilizers, then irrigation, protection from weeds, harvesting, and last step is the storage. Okay. Then, in this lesson, first we studied about the crop plants, crops. Two types of crops, carrot crops and rabi crops. Like plants, animals also give us different types of food. Meat, milk, then fish, etc. we are getting from animals. Many people living in the coastal areas, they consume fish as a major part of their diet. The fish is good for health. The fish containing vitamin D. Vitamin D, do you know what is the function of vitamin D? Vitamin D, it is important for our bones and muscles. In the previous class, we learned about the several agricultural activities. Like we have just seen like agricultural activities like preparation of soil, sowing, etc. Then, like plants, the animals are reared like to home or farm to give proper shelter, food and care. When this is done on large scale, and this is called animal husbandry. What is called? Animal husbandry. Animal husbandry. Animal husbandry. Animal husbandry is the rearing of animals. The animals are reared at home or farm to give proper shelter, food and care. And this is called animal husbandry. What is called? Animal husbandry. Okay dear children, this lesson is over. Our first lesson is over. Everybody should read the textbook carefully. All the fill in the blanks, true or false, match the following. Questions are coming from these lessons only. So, everybody should read the textbook carefully. If you have any doubt, you call me. The next class, we will meet again and start the next lesson. Dear children, I hope you understood this lesson very well. If you have any doubt, you call me. Okay, dear children, thank you. Bye.